On the album, you mentioned how, you know, you were inspired by bands like Suicidal Tendencies.
Absolutely.
And Slayer.
Yes.
And you wanted an outlet just for your guitarist, Ernie, to have some shred.
And I was intrigued by a mosh pit.
Yeah. Oh, that's right.
I went to Europe, and we would do rap, and I seen a mosh pit, and I played in front of one. And once you play in front of a mosh pit, you always want to play in front of a mosh pit. It's like the most cool shit. And so I'm like, damn, but I knew that they would rock harder, like off Welcome to the Terror Dome, the more up-tempo shit.
Yeah.
And then me being a rock fan, I was like, let's make a band.
Yeah.
And I'm always like, well, what'll make it unique? Well, we'll do music that's a mix of Black Sabbath, Slayer, and Suicidal, but the content will be unique because I'll keep singing about the same shit I
yeah.
do.
Yeah, and no, I feel like a lot, like, white people cannot get away with singing about the things that you sing about.
Well, they don't know about it.
Right.
You can sing about it if it's firsthand. You know, that's the key to the game. It's like people want firsthand accounts, not secondhand or make-believe accounts. You know, so I can never sing about being in a trailer park. I never been there, don't know about it. Eminem can sing about it, though. Mm-hmm. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it has to be authentic, and people respect that. You know, so I like, even when we came out with the imagery, it's like, I listen to Dio, I know about all the, you know, but I ain't seen the devil, personally. But I have seen a motherfucker with a 357. So that's my devil, right? Mm-hmm. That's my devil. So our imagery is around the evil I've seen and what I deal with, my hell, my neighborhood, and what I go through. And that's my zone. And I kind of stay in my lane.
Do you keep your ear to the underground of metal? Do you try to keep up with what's going on, or is it kind of what your friends show you?
A little bit. Like, I listen to WSOU, Seton Hall University, mm-hmm. out here. They play a lot of metal. I know what I like, but I know what I'm... Like, put it like this. Like, I like the aggression of, like, heavy metal, but I like to hear the words because I'm a lyricist. And a lot of stuff with the heavy, you know... What do you call the vocals? I don't know what the fuck they saying. I'm like, yeah. I'm missing it. Like, I'm friends with Chris Barnes. So I listen to... Well, of course, but I'm listening to the new album, Torment.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So I don't know what the fuck he said. So I read the lyric sheet. I'm like, you can't come spend the night over my house, motherfucker. What the fuck? Are you crazy? Like, you talking about, you know, pulling... But it's dope, but at the same time, the shit is crazy. But I wish I could hear what you're saying. Now, when I work with Slayer... Like, Tommy, he uses closer to clean vocals, like, mm-hmm. even though he's yelling. But he told me, he said, well, if I can't hear what you're saying, how can I hear what you're saying?
That's good advice for vocalists out there.
I mean, you know, so I'm not wasting my time. I'm trying to say some shit, so I want to make sure you can hear it. But people are like, well, you don't sing. I'm like, because I can't sing. If I could sing, I'd fucking try to sing.
You'd be Frank Sinatra.
I sung on The Winner Loses. I sung on Hey Joe, tribute to Jimi Hendrix. But I know I can't fucking belt it out. Like, you know, so you stay in your range
yeah.
of what you can do.